Hi everyone, welcome back to Vedic Life Coaching. Thank you so much for joining me and welcome to a timeless pick a card reading. You can see the desk has changed. This is my actual desk. This is where I sit and I do my work. I do my reading notes. I do everything right here. And what I thought I would do, I just felt inspired. I was actually putting together notes for a session that I have on tomorrow. And I'm going well on the notes. I've been very focused and disciplined and good. But then all of a sudden, I just got this strong thing. Hey, see what it'd be like to film a pick a card right here. And I thought, I've never done that before. And I thought, okay, let's get the camera out. And I was just experimenting. I was just playing. And I was just shuffling the cards. And, you know, I was like shuffling and then like popping a card here, and I thought, oh, that actually looks kind of good. And I thought we could have three cards and it could be nice and just a mini brief sort of a reading. Every now and then you'll see my phone light up. Hopefully it won't do that, because I tried, what if I put it like that? But then you'll see everything slides. See, it kind of slides. It doesn't really work. So my phone doesn't usually come on, so let's not worry about that. But yeah, I mean, I was just sat here and I thought, and what is this card? This is the Ten of Pentacles. I mean, yeah, that's perfect. I thought I could just do the reading here. And it'll be a mini reading of three cards, and it'll be just some kind of, I felt like there's a need to do a keep going message. I feel like people need to keep going, and we need to keep going. Why do we need to keep going? Because of the Ten of Pentacles, because we're all building the future. We're all building this, aren't we? You know, and I just thought, yeah, let's do this right here. And I just felt inspired and I thought, okay, let's go for it. So, and what I'll do as well is I'm just going to record this all in one hit. So this will all fit on one memory card thing. And that way it's super easy to edit as well. So yeah, because tomorrow I was hoping to have an archetypes video done, but I haven't had the time, guys. Too many readings, too many sessions, which is great. So group number one, let's just check in with you. Let's see what's going on. And we'll have three cards, a very quick reading, but I feel like there's some kind of keep going message for everybody. Everybody maybe needs a little boost or something, you know. Oh wow, look at that. We've got the Four of Wands come out for you. So you are working towards creating this lovely scene. And there's a keep going message here. There's a it's gonna happen message here. It's really super beautiful. We've got these two little birds here. We've got these two people here. But the Four of Wands is more than just two people. This is a family home life that you're going to love. This is friends. This is, look at that. I mean, you can accommodate a lot of friends, a lot of people, a lot of good times. You're working hard. It's all good. So let's see what comes through this tarot deck. And then I'll get one Vedic astrology card, and that is going to be the new lean reading. I mean, I think this should work quite nicely. So I'll take one of those, because yeah, I haven't been doing pick a card for a little while. I'll just do them when I can, guys. Just doing my best. You guys know that. All right, take one of these. Okay. All right, we'll see what comes. So this one is, we've got Four of Wands, we've got the Two of Pentacles. Okay, a little bit of a holding pattern here. Quite a lot of juggling. All right. Oh, lovely, Jupiter in the seventh house. We've got here gains through marriage, achieves fame, excels as a judge, journalist, counselor, sensitive to others' feelings, can exceed father's achievements. This is incredible. This is so beautiful. I think this is a real acknowledgement from the divine that you are doing so well. You're on track as well. I feel like you're on track, but there's just delays, juggling, things are possibly up in the air as well for you at the moment. There's perhaps no, what do I want to say here? No, it's kind of like the security or the stability that you crave isn't here right now, but you're doing a great job of moving towards it. So just keep going. Okay, so that keep going message, I really do think that is strong here in group one. Let's see what's happening for group two. I'm going to put these back in the decks. I'm going to see what's going on for group number two. These are brief readings, guys. It's kind of all I've got time for at the moment. All right, group two, let's feel into the energy of group two. What's happening here? Draw a card from here and we'll get a feel for what the energy of group two is. Here we go. All right, King of Swords. Wow, that's an incredible King of Swords card. Okay, let's take a look at this. Oh, I love this. Do you know, this is, I was chatting with someone today and talking about unfold your own myth and re-mythologize your past. And for me, this has got a mythical feel to it. It's kind of like a storyteller feel. It's a, you can invent and create anything you want. At this point in time, there's something about you needing to remember that, that you're in charge, or you've got the pen in your hand, or you're writing the story, or the power is in your hands. This really does have that feel to it. And you can be anything you want. You can be a King of Swords with this incredible long hair. You know, you can be anything you want. Imagine it, enjoy it, whatever it is. Create this vision, even though, and it's, there is a bit of a vision of a message of, even though society may not accept it or expect it or whatever it is, no, don't you worry about society. You create the incredible thing that you want to create. So there's something very creative going on in your world right now that is clearly very beautiful, but perhaps not what society expects. Okay, I love that. I love things that kind of, you know, throw society's ideals on its head, you know. You're like, well, that's my King of Swords. That's great. Oh, fantastic. Ace of Wands. Yeah, enormous creative energy here. You are enormously creative at this time. And if we look at this as well, you can see here that this is, you know, it's like a wand, it's a needle, this is my iPad pencil here. Like, it's that kind of thing. It's like, you are just so creative right now. This is incredible. Swords is air, so okay. So maybe it's something intellectual you're doing. Maybe you're writing a song, a book. There's something maybe you're writing, definitely. That kind of energy here. Get one more. Okay. Oh, look at that. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I love it. Mars in the 10th house. This is the Midas touch. This is whatever you touch turns to gold. You are very creative at this time. Leader who takes bold steps. Earns much wealth, faces tests, affection and respect towards father, healthy, strong, and enlightened. This is an absolutely incredible card to receive with these two, and it's really showing that you're going to be successful in your venture. Whatever it is that you put your mind to at this time, whatever it is that you're working on, whatever it is that you touch, it's going to go good. Okay, so there's a keep going message here as well, just like with group number one. So I do feel like with all of the groups, there's some kind of keep going message. But for you, group number two, you are enormously creative at this time. And this might all be happening in the ethers as well. This might not be anything that has materialized just yet, but you are doing a brilliant job. Keep going, keep being creative. That is the main thing here. Fantastic. All right, let's take a look at the third group, see what's going on. Group number three. Okay, oh, Five of Swords. Alrighty, that really wants to be here. So take a look at the Five of Swords. You've got five come through. Five is Mercury, but five is also conflict as per tarot. It's conflict, it's change, it's... Yeah, this is an interesting energy here. You could be conflicted about something, a situation or something from your past or something along those lines. We'll take a look. We'll see what else is going on here. That is the Five of Swords. We'll see what's going on here. I'm not getting a keep going message here. I'll tell you that right now. This is also mind. It's kind of like mind is strongly at play here as well. Oh, the Lovers. All right. And let's take a look at, we don't want to block her face. There we go. Third card, right? Moon in the third. Loves traveling, good writer, sensitive communicator, logical, knowledgeable. Spouse is boss. If afflicted, finds little peace of mind. All right, well, this is interesting, group three. I do think, I mean, quite a literal reading of these three cards is to say that perhaps you're having a conflict with a lover. There's some disagreement here. I'm definitely not getting a keep going message. I'm getting a slow down message. Or even a pause message that maybe you need to pause. Maybe you need to reflect. Any upcoming travel is going to be good for you if you travel. But equally, this traveling could be traveling through the mind. This could be a really good time to escape into books or the writings of other people. It feels like, and the moon is involved, so there is a bit of confusion here. I think possibly there's confusion energy here. There might be need for a bit of a pause on something, or and possibly just for you to regain your energy. Let's just take one more from here, just see if there's any further guidance. Oh wow, okay. Yep, you've got to leave something behind. This is the Six of Swords. So you've got to leave something behind. And I do think that this is in connection with another person. So maybe you have to leave a way of being behind or a certain mindset that you have. Maybe you always do things a certain way. Maybe you need to leave that way of doing things behind. It could be that you need to leave a person, that's true as well. But it could be that you need to leave a certain way of doing things behind. And I think we do have the Lovers here. That is also choice, but this is also self-love as well, I think, is going to be a solution for you at this time. Self-love is definitely the answer, group number three. So I hope you enjoy these little mini pick a card bursts. Let me know in the comments below if this has been helpful. I do hope so. And I want to thank you so much for tuning in. And I look forward to seeing you next time.